Every summer, the heart of the Great Lakes is witness to an extraordinary cultural phenomenon. A bold international musical event where the world's most celebrated artists gather to perform chamber music. Passion and artistry move us to collectively experience the fullest range and depth of emotion with every crescendo, turn of the page, and stroke of the bow. Chamber music at its best, fresh, dynamic, soul-stirring. The Great Lakes Chamber Music Festival, where great music comes to play. Welcome to opening night of the 2021 Virtual Great Lakes Chamber Music Festival. I'm Paul Watkins, Artistic Director of the festival. It's my pleasure to share this experience of 8 concerts over the next 2 weeks, 5 of which were performed outdoors in June to a live audience, as well as 3 concerts recorded by festival artists that are exclusive to this virtual festival in collaboration with the Detroit Institute of Arts. Tonight, we present Reveries Old and New, which was recorded on June 13th under the tent on the beautiful grounds of Temple Beth El in Bloomfield Hills, Michigan. All 3 pieces in this program offer solace and gain strength through inspiration from the past, natural beauty, and memory. They also use instrumental color to create a dreamlike atmosphere. This evening, you will also hear from Festival Board co-chair Michael Gehabe and pianist Soyeon Kate Lee in special interviews that were recorded during the recent festival, but not heard by the in-person festival audience. Tonight's performance is sponsored by the Paul Katz Endowed Cello Fund in memory of Morris D. Baker. And now, let's get to the music. Our first piece is the cello sonata by Claude Debussy, written in 1915 as the composer faced the despair of the First World War and his own personal health struggles. What emerged from these dark times was a dense work packed with effervescent dialogue, exquisite harmonies, and sparkling effects.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm Michael Gehabe, and I'm the co-chair of the Great Lakes Chamber Music Festival. I share that responsibility and honor with my wife, Jenny. The role of the festival in the community, and I would define that as many communities, is to bring beautiful music, artistic virtuosity, in unique settings such as this, bringing great friends, great artists, and great music together. And in a venue like this, you experience when music comes to play. What we are looking to do now is broaden our community outreach, just bring the same experiences in some different genres of music as we, in fact, expand our reach within the various communities within the metropolitan Detroit area. The great privilege that each of us has hosting the artists is getting to know them. And you get to know them as their everyday lives in some sense, but you also begin to recognize the extraordinary gifts and talents that they have that take tenacity and take persistence to in fact perfect those talents in order to bring special experiences to each one of us. And after they've performed and they come back to your house and you sit down and you have a drink and you have a little food and you get to reminisce and you get to see them wind down.
Thank you, Michael Gehabe, for your insights and for the extraordinary hospitality shown by both you and Ginny during the festival. Next, we're pleased to present a work by vocalist, violinist, producer, and Pulitzer Prize-winning composer Caroline Shaw. She was inspired to write The Evergreen while walking through a forest in British Columbia. There's wisdom in these trees, she thought to herself, and this piece is her offering to one particular rugged, towering, warped tree in that forest. Shaw's delight in exploring the textural possibilities of the string quartet is obvious. She conjures a wonderful out-of-doors atmosphere, which is occasionally augmented by the bird life surrounding our tent. The Evergreen is performed by the Viano String Quartet, one of the extraordinarily talented young ensembles in our Schaus Institute program.
Thank you. Hello everybody, my name is Soyeon Kate Lee. I'm a pianist and I live currently in Cincinnati, Ohio. Well, actually, it's a little bit of a funny story. Besides that, my parents really had music in the background all the time. When I first moved to the States at the age of 9, my dad was doing research, and of course, I had no friends. I had just landed here, and of all places, it was in Morgantown, West Virginia. And although I had taken some piano lessons back in Korea, it really propelled me to practice and get back into it because I literally had no other life. And it took me a while to make friends and to learn English. And so I think that time in West Virginia was really fruitful for me and fateful, because I think without it, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing today. You know, I have a terrible singing voice, and I would really love to be able to sing. And I would love to, because there's so much, of course, as musicians, we can learn from singers, and to be able to do that on my own, I think, would be wonderful. during school, you know, there are many people who have inspired me. Of course, my teachers have, but the great recordings of, you know, Schnabel and Horowitz, Rubinstein, Cortot, Rostropovich. But I think, I don't know, role model for me embodies something that's not just music, you know, it's just sort of everything. It encompasses their entire humanity. And I think when I think about who is my role model in my life, it'll probably be the ordinary people around me, you know, like my parents and people I meet on a daily basis. Yeah.
Thank you, Kate, for your heartfelt comments. It was a pleasure to collaborate with you in the Debussy Sonata, and we were all in awe of your performance of the demanding piano part in the final piece on this programme, Fauré's Piano Quartet No. 2 in G minor. This magnificent work, at times impassioned, forceful and driving, contains an adagio that, to quote Aaron Copland, is the crowning movement of the quartet, a long sigh of infinite tenderness, a long moment of quiet melancholy and nostalgic charm. I'm joined in this performance by Kate Lee, Tessa Lark, and Cindy Wu. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for inviting us into your homes this evening. It has been a pleasure being your host for tonight's performance of the virtual Great Lakes Chamber Music Festival. Join us again Monday night at 7 p.m. as Philip Setzer hosts our next concert, a Schaus showcase entitled Seeking Home, featuring the Ivalis Quartet and the Viano String Quartet. I will return as your host on Wednesday night and will be joined on the stage by Kate Lee, Philip Setzer, tenor Nicholas Pahn, and the Ivalis Quartet. Please visit our website for more information about the 2021 virtual festival, greatlakeschambermusic.org. Thank you again for joining us, and good night.